spiritual cycle of birth and death, that which culminates the spiritual perfection, that which enhances and totally disentangles the illusory bondage of human being, enabling the person to reach his natural patriotic abode, that is the kingdom of God or the lap of the God. The dip of jnana, the dip of greater wisdom offered by the shastras are known as parasadhana, and that is known as vishesha dharma. For, I have already told in my Gita lecture, for this promulgation of ordinary dharmas, God need not descend. That he can do through his delegates. For truth, for respecting elders, for perfection in ritualism, for Vedic wisdom, respect and practices, God can easily delegate Vyasa, Vasishta and other rishis. And as he is the indweller of all these personalities, he can activate these persons to promulgate the dharma for which his descendants is meaningless. He descends only for the propagation of the Vishesha Dharma, the craving that which is spinning him inside, that he must have the unison of the time immemorial separation due to this material bondage, the time immemorial separation which has totally isolated him from the samsaris, the binded souls, that he want to make this gap filled by intimacy, realization and service. So for that only he descends, in selection of such a special soul which is ready to give everything, not take everything from God. So for promulgation of these dharmas, we can use lot of sadhanas, instruments. There are three types of sadhanas. One is literal, by composing literatures and doing commentaries to already existing literatures and making new books, research reviews and elucidations. This type of book contribution is a way of service. It may be even a book, even an article in a journal, and it may be even a magazine. There are several methods of such a bibliographic publications. So this type of promulgation of wisdom by the first mode of media is known as bibliographic, and second is phonographic. And phonographic is the sound transmission. If it is direct, it is in the case of a spiritual master attending towards the disciples. If it is impersonal, it may be in the form of tape recorders, CDs, etc., which are available now. But we are getting the mercy of that particular acharya. There are so many dikshas of the preceptor. One is sparsha diksha, second is smarana diksha, and third is nayana diksha. There are so many dikshas are there. By the touch of the master, by the vision of the master, by the thought of the master, by the mercy of the master, these type of various associations, it gives some extra energy which makes this penetration of wisdom an automatic process which need not be a manual, just as we refer from books. If you read a book, the process is manual. You have to observe the things from the books and assimilate in your mind. But if you get the same message from an acharya, it is just like something from the mother's hand. If you get paddy from the field, it will be covered with all the unnecessaries and they have to be processed. If you get it from a shop, it will be processed but yet to be cooked and to be decorated with sumptuous other side dishes and to be then given with affection. But the same thing, if you get from the mother's hand, it will be well cooked, it will be well served with all essentials. So that which we get from the Vedas, that which we get from the Vedas, it is like the paddy in the field. That which we get from books and other simple sources, it is just like the rice from the shop. But that which we get from a merciful potential acharya's vision, embracement, that is certainly something which is fed by the own hands of one's own mother, which not only has the power of wisdom but the power of affection and the craving of the acharya and the real sincerity of the acharya in uplifting the person from the path of murk, enlightening to the path of that illustrious transcendental divine effulgent wisdom. So that type of promulgation in the second variety, that is the personal, is from acharya. From acharya, acharyas are of different types of people are there in acharyas. There are people who are initiators, there are people who could preach, there are some people like tutors, they could teach. Depending upon their level of spiritual attainment, they are graded. The initiating person is said to be the supreme. And the person who just preaches is a mediocre, and just a person who teaches is just like a book's exposition. and he is said to be inferior, tertiary. These type of propagations are there. These propagations are manual, and now we have selected the most potential alluring medium which could attract thousands of people and which could imprint inside unerasably all of our messages, which is both attractive and informative. That is the media of a channel. That is the third thing which you have taken today. The other two things I have described earlier, just as the books, these things are monotonous unless the person is a bookworm, bibliomaniac. He cannot read books. Nowadays, reading books, totally it has become an obsolete quality. Books are now most preferably used as pillows.